Drawing a rabbit stamp is a happy thing. As for this rabbit, everyone can draw it. It's not something that only I can. Drawing it makes everyone happy, just to celebrate the coming New Year. Thank you, everyone. That's how Mr. Huang Yongyu commented on his controversial design of the 2023 Year of the Rabbit stamps. Not everyone is happy with the stamps, but these two are the last stamps designed by this painter, as he passed away on 13th June at the age of 98. In this episode, let's talk about the stamps designed by Mr. Huang Yongyu and the painter himself. The most famous artwork of Mr. Huang is the 1980 Red Monkey stamp, which is also one of China's most famous stamps. After that, he designed the 2016 Year of the Monkey stamps, as well as the controversial zodiac stamps of this year. Honestly, that was all I knew about this artist before his death. Huang Yongyu was only a name associated with several Chinese zodiac stamps for me. In recent days, I read several articles and watched some interviews about him. Based on my limited knowledge of him, he was such an interesting and delightful artist. He maintained his childlike spirit until the very end of his life. Please let me share what I learned of Mr. Huang, and let's remember this beloved artist. Huang Yongyu was born on 9th August 1924 in Changde, Hunan Province. Although both of his parents were intellectual, he was unable to receive the best education due to the turbulent times of war. In 1937, he went to Fujian Province to live with his uncle and attend secondary school, but unfortunately he had to drop out later. But it was also during this period that he showed his talent for painting. In 1941, during the period of the war against Japan, he joined the field service corps to work as graphic artist, engaging in tasks such as painting backdrops and creating posters. After the war, he worked in Shanghai and Hong Kong successively, engaged in music, art education, and woodcut work. In 1948, he served as the art editor for the Tai Kung Po newspaper in Hong Kong, creating illustrations for news reports. In 1953, he moved to Beijing, where he taught at woodcut painting department of the Central Academy of Fine Arts. From the mid-1970s onwards, he served as a professor at the academy and as the vice chairman of the Chinese Artists Association. The first stamp set Mr. Huang participated in designing was the stamps issued in 1958 with the theme of forestry construction. The design was based on his woodcut printing work. The serial number of the stamps is 227. You can check out my video about the numbering system to learn more. The second stamp he participated in designing was the famous Red Monkey stamp. In 1979, stamp designer Shao Bolin visited Huang Yongyu and proposed the idea of having Mr. Huang paint a set of animal stamps. Huang Yongyu readily agreed and suggested why not issue a set of zodiac animal stamps. Shao thought it was a great idea and reported the suggestion to the leadership of Stamp Issuing Bureau. Eventually, this proposal was approved, and that's the start of Chinese zodiac stamps. The monkey painted by Huang Yongyu was based on his pet monkey named Yiwo. During that time, he was grieving over the loss of his beloved monkey, and he said, "I want the whole world to know how adorable my departed monkey was." Finally, 4.4 million red monkey stamps were issued, which is not a small number, but it is an expensive stamp due to its special significance. The Red Monkey stamp is not only beloved by Chinese people, but also by the collectors all over the world. The third set of stamps designed by Huang Yongyu was the Bering Crane stamp issued in 1986, and then was the stamp for the 10th World Congress on Tourism and Travel issued in 2010. This is a painting of Lotus. And in 2015, after 36 years, Mr. Huang designed another set of the Year of the Monkey stamps when he was already 91 years old. The two monkey stamps designed this time depict different scenes. One stamp is titled Blessing of the Agile Monkey, showing a male monkey holding onto the tree branch with one hand while carrying a peach in the other happily swaying in the air with a smile on its face. The other stamp is titled Happiness and Longevity, portraying a female monkey embarrassing two baby monkeys, symbolizing a harmonious family reunion. Initially, the postal authority considered using a mother monkey holding a baby monkey, but Huang Yongyu suggested that as the government was going to abolish the one-child policy, so why not depict two baby monkeys? So the final design was like this. The last set of stamps he designed was the Year of the Rabbit stamps for this year. The design sparked a lot of controversy and criticism, particularly regarding the blue rabbit featured on the first stamp. People, including myself, did not understand why he depicted a rabbit in such manner. Furthermore, people believed that this style of artwork was not suitable for the New Year's atmosphere. But after I saw more of his paintings, I understood that's just his style, which reflects his sense of humor. This painting features the wild boar titled Fighting for My Humiliated Cousin. This one features the parrot titled The Bird is a Good Bird, but Just Too Talkative. And this picture depicted a conference of the Monkey King, but all the monkeys are busy with their mobile phones. And these are two paintings about the tortoise and the hare. And one of my favorites is his self-portrait at the age of 90. He was just a funny old man with a childlike heart. And here is that of his 12 zodiac animals painting. You can learn more about his style from them. Still, this is definitely not one of my favorite Chinese zodiac stamps, but it is the last artwork that Mr. Huang left us. And I found there is a doll version, which I think is more lovely than the two-dimensional version. From an interview of last year, Mr. Huang said that he is not afraid to die and don't want to leave anything such as ashes or be put into an ancestral temple. In his will, he stated that he did not want a memorial service and wished for his ashes to be returned to the nature as fertilizer. And he even joked, "After I die, first tickle me to see if I laugh." This is Huang Yongyu, a childlike artist who loves nature, and now he returned to nature. Rest in peace. As always, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe, and follow me on social media if you haven't. And also don't forget to check the related links in the description, including the interviews of Mr. Huang. Thank you so much for watching. See you next time.